Why, this is Plus Eldridge, the commander-in-chief of the Army of France. My jolly girl, but you look great. Honest you do. And you fellas say you take my advice, will you? I want to have a nice, quiet, heart-to-heart talk with the men. Girls, pull it up like you two talk to these fellas. Say, boys, now is your time to get married. You take my advice and get married, and when you marry, marry your widow. That's right. George Washington married a widow. George Dewey married a widow. I married a widow. None of you young, silly, simpering, dumb, chewing, Simpson girls for me. No, sir. Give me the good, sad old widow every time. She's the stuff. You don't have to hang around front of her house on a cold winter night, making love to her, freezing your feet off. Scared to go in, fear the old man will hand you one and make you do a huffery butt out the back door. You don't have to ask her every night for a year to marry you. And every time you ask, I don't know whether I want to get married or not. Not so widow. All you gotta do is go down into the neighborhood where there's three or four good healthy widows living, that's all. Go down there and whisper to the four winds of heaven that you are desirous of entering into the holy bands of wedlock. And if one of them don't land you inside of 24 hours, well, it's because you take to the tall trees and pull the trees up after you. Now, just how much better off you are when you marry a widow. Why, you marry a young girl in the first 4 years of your wedded life, you're worried to death. You're scared you ain't going to get your furniture paid for. You don't know what minute the installment man will back a wagon up against the house and take away all your goods.